Dear students, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor of Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Magali Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again on the video lecture series on the subject heat and mass transfer. And today the lecture number is 208 on the module Convection Heat Transfer. And in this session, we will be solving problem on the forced convection external flow. So in the previous lecture, so we discussed the forced convection external flow correlations using the heat and mass transfer data book, and using these correlations we solve the problem now. So at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to solve problems in the forced convection external flow, that is the learning outcome for the session. And the steps to solve the problem in the forced convection heat transfer: first, write down the given data and draw the diagram. So represent the data in the form of a diagram. Particularly in the diagram, you have to mention the geometry of the surface, either flat plate, a cylinder or a sphere, and write down all the information whatever given in the problem. Then find the film temperature using the equation available in the heat and mass transfer data book, and you take the properties of the fluid from the heat and mass transfer data book. So the fluid may be air, water, engine oil, any fluid. So you take the properties from the heat and mass transfer data book. Then calculate the Reynolds number. So based on the geometry, whether it is flat plate or cylinder or the sphere, and classify the flow. So when the Reynolds number is less than 5 × 10⁵, the flow is laminar. Otherwise, when the Reynolds number is more than 5 × 10⁵, the flow will be turbulent. Then, based on the flow configuration, based on the geometry, and based on the Prandtl number, you take the Nusselt equation. So, Nusselt equation from the heat and mass transfer data book, based on the laminar flow, turbulent flow, based on the flat plate, cylinder, or the sphere. Then from the Nusselt number, you calculate the heat transfer coefficient. So Nusselt number equal to HL by K or HD by K, depending on the geometry. Then calculate the rate of heat transfer, Q equal to HA into delta T. Then write down the answer. So at the end of the solution, you write down, summarize the answer as per the requirement in the question paper. And this is the heat and mass transfer data book required for taking the properties and the equations for solving a problem in the forced convection external flow. And we take example number 7. An electrically heated plate dissipates heat by convection at the rate of 8000 watts per meter square into ambient air at 25 degrees Celsius. If the surface of the hot plate is at 125 degrees Celsius, calculate the heat transfer coefficient for convection between the plate and the air. So the heat flux is given, Q equal to 8000 watts per meter square. The fluid temperature is 25 degrees Celsius and the surface temperature is 125 degrees Celsius. The heat transfer coefficient straight away, H equal to Q by TW minus T infinity, which is 8000 divided by 125 minus 25 equal to 80 watts per meter square Kelvin. So the answer to the problem, heat transfer coefficient is 80 watts per meter square Kelvin. The crankcase of an IC engine measuring 80 cm by 20 cm may be idealized as a flat plate. The engine runs at 90 km per hour and the crankcase is cooled by air flowing past it at the same speed. Calculate the heat loss from the crankcase maintained at 85 degrees Celsius to the ambient air at 15 degrees Celsius. Due to the road induced vibration, the boundary air becomes turbulent from the leading edge itself. And the given data, length of the crankcase is 0.8 meter, width of the crankcase is 0.2 meter. U infinity is 90 kilometers per hour, which is 25 meters per second. And the fluid temperature is 15 degrees Celsius. And the wall temperature is 85 degrees Celsius. And the properties of air from the heat and mass transfer data book, page number 34, at a film temperature. So film temperature is TW plus T infinity divided by 2. Which is 85 plus 15 divided by 2. So calculating, it is 50 degrees Celsius. Then the properties of air from the heat and mass transfer data book. So the properties required are mu, Prandtl number, thermal conductivity and density of the air. You take all the properties from the heat and mass transfer data book. And calculate the Reynolds number. Reynolds number equal to U infinity L divided by nu kinematic viscosity. So 25 into 0.8 divided by 17.95 10 power minus 6, which is 1.1 10 power 6. So the value is greater than 5 into 10 power 5. The flow is turbulent. For turbulent flow, the result number from the heat and mass transfer data book, page number 114, equation 1.4.1. So Nusselt number equal to 0.037, Reynolds number to the power 0.8 and Prandtl number to the power 0.33. So Nusselt number equal to HL by K, and substituting the Reynolds number is 1.1 10 power 6 to the power 0.8 and Prandtl number is 0.698 to the power 0.33. So Nusselt number equal to 2237.63 and the heat transfer coefficient H equal to 2237.63 into K by L, which is 2237.60 into 0.02826 divided by 0.8 equal to 79 watts per meter square Kelvin. So the heat transfer coefficient for the turbulent flow is 79 watts per meter square Kelvin, and the heat loss from the crankcase is, it is considered as a flat plate, so HEA into TW minus T infinity, so area equal to W into L. So 79 into 0.2 into 0.8 into 85 minus 15 equal to 884.8 watts. So the answer to the problem, the heat loss from the crankcase equal to 884.8 watts. Then page number, example number 9, assume that a man can be represented as a cylinder of 0.3 meter radius and a height of 1.7 meter with a surface temperature of 30 degrees Celsius. Calculate the heat he would lose while standing in a 36 kilometers per hour wind at 10 degree Celsius. So from the given data, the diameter of the cylinder, so the man can be considered as a cylinder of diameter, cylinder of radius is given 0.3 meter. So you have to calculate the diameter, which is 0.6 meter. Length of the height of the man is 1.7 meter. So TW equal to 30 degree Celsius surface temperature, and T infinity fluid temperature, air temperature is 10 degrees Celsius, and the velocity is 36 kilometers per hour, which is 10 meters per second. And now we take the properties of the air from the heat and mass transfer data book and the page number 34 at the film temperature. The film temperature is TW plus T infinity divided by 2, which is 20 degrees Celsius. So the properties of air at 20 degrees Celsius. So the kinematic viscosity is 15.06 in 10 power minus 6 meters square per second. Prandtl number is 0.703. Thermal conductivity is 0.02593. And the density is 1.205. So we calculate the Reynolds number. So this is cylindrical dimension. So Reynolds number equal to U infinity T divided by nu, which is 10 into 0.6, the diameter divided by 15.06 in 10 power minus 6, which is 3.98 in 10 power 5. And the flow is laminar. So for the Nusselt number for the flow over cylinder, so from the page number 116 on the heat and mass transfer data book, equation 2.1.1, the Nusselt number equal to C into Reynolds number to the power M and Prandtl number to the power 0.333. The value of C equal to 0.0266 and M equal to 0.805 for Reynolds number equal to 3.98 10 power 5. And we calculate the Nusselt number, HD by K equal to 0.0266 into 3.98 to the power 10 into 10 power 5 to the power 0.805 into 0.703 to the power 0.333, which is 762.39. Then the heat transfer coefficient, H equal to Nusselt number into K by D, which is 762.39 into 0.02593 divided by 0.6, which is 32.95 watts per meter square Kelvin. And the heat loss by the man, which is HA into delta T. So H is 32.95, area equal to pi D into L. So pi into 0.6 into L equal to 1.7 meter and delta T equal to 30 minus 10 equal to 2110.5 watts. So the answer to the problem, heat loss by the man is 2110.5 watts. We take another example. air stream of 30 degrees Celsius moves with the velocity of 0.3 meters per second across a 100 watt electric bulb. If the bulb is approximated as a sphere of 0.06 meter sphere diameter sphere, estimate the surface temperature of the bulb if 8.5% of energy is lost by convection to the surrounding. And the T infinity, temperature of the air, surrounding air is 30 degrees Celsius, velocity is 0.3 meters per second, the power of the bulb is 100 watts, diameter of the bulb is 0.06 meter and energy loss is 8.5%. So the properties of air at 30 degrees Celsius, so we take the properties of air nu equal to 16 in 10 power minus 6 watts per meter square, Prandtl number equal to 0.701, thermal conductivity is 0.02675 and the density equal to 1.165. We calculate the Reynolds number for the spherical system, Reynolds number equal to U infinity D divided by nu. So 0.3 into 0.06 divided by 16 into 10 power minus 6 equal to 1125. So for the sphere, we take this equation, Nusselt number equation for the flow over sphere, page number 120, equation number 3, HD by K equal to 0.37 into Reynolds number to the power 0.6. So the 0.37 into 1125 to the power 0.6 equal to 25.05. And heat transfer coefficient, so the heat transfer coefficient H equal to 25.05 into K by D, which is 25.05 into 0.02675 divided by 0.06, which is 11.17 watts per meter square Kelvin. And heat loss by convection is only 8.5%, so which is 0.085 into 100 equal to 8.5 watts. So Q, heat transfer, equal to H into surface area of the sphere is pi d square or 4 pi r square, so into Tw minus T infinity. So substituting 8.5 equal to 11.17 into pi into 0.06 square into Tw minus 30. So the wall temperature is 70.3 degree Celsius. So the surface temperature of the bulb is 70.3 degree Celsius. So the answer to the problem, surface temperature of the bulb is 70.3 degree Celsius. And we take example number 11, a heated sphere having diameter of 30 mm is maintained at a temperature of 90 degrees Celsius and is placed in water stream at 20 degrees Celsius. The water flow velocity is 3.5 meters per second. So calculate the heat loss from the sphere. So the given data for the problem, diameter equal to 0.03 meter, wall temperature is 90 degrees Celsius, fluid temperature is 20 degrees Celsius, and the velocity of the fluid is 33.5 meters per second. Now the properties of water from the heat and mass transfer data book, page number 22, at the film temperature. So film temperature is 90 plus 20 divided by 2, which is 55 degrees Celsius. So the water properties at 55 degrees Celsius. We have property for 40 degrees Celsius and 60 degrees Celsius. So we take the property for 55 degrees Celsius. So by interpolation, so we have kinematic viscosity, Prandtl number and K. So kinematic viscosity is 0.15425 10 power minus 6, Prandtl number equal to 3.35 and thermal conductivity is 0.645475. So we calculate the Reynolds number. Reynolds number equal to U infinity D divided by nu. So 3.5 into 0.03 divided by 0.15425 into 10 power minus 6, which is 6.81 into 10 power 5. For the sphere, flow of water over a sphere, the Nusselt equation HD by K, for the sphere, it is given by 0.97 plus 0.68 Reynolds number to the power 5 divided by Prandtl number to the power minus 0.3 equal to, so substituting numerical value, so 0.97 into 0.68 into 6.81 10 power 5 to the power 0.5 divided by Prandtl number to the power 3.35 to the power minus 0.3, which is equal to 807.88. Then the heat transfer coefficient, so H value equal to 807.88 into K by D, which is 807.88 into 0.645475 divided by 0.03, which is 17,382 0.2 watts per meter square Kelvin. And the heat loss by convection from the sphere, which is HQ equal to H into area pi d square into TW minus T infinity, which is 3000. So substituting 17382.2 into pi into 0.03 square into 90 minus 20 equal to 3438.5 watts. So the heat loss from the sphere is 3438.5 watts. And example number 12, air at 27 degrees Celsius and 1 atmosphere flows over a flat plate at a speed of 2 meters per second. Calculate the boundary layer thickness at a distance of 20 centimeter and 40 centimeter from the leading edge of the plate. Calculate the mass flow rate that enters the boundary layer between x equal to 20 centimeter and x equal to 40 centimeter. So viscosity of the air is 1.85 in 10 power minus 5 kilograms per meter second. Assume unit depth in the z direction. So the given data, 1 atmospheric pressure, temperature is 27 degrees Celsius, velocity is 2 meters per second, x1 equal to 0.2 meter, x2 equal to 0.4 meter, and the absolute viscosity is given as 1.85 in 10 power minus 5 kilograms per meter second. The density of the air from the pressure and temperature, rho equal to P by RT, which is 101325 divided by 287 plus into 27 plus 273, so which is 1.177 kilograms per meter cube. So at x1 equal to 0.2 meter, Reynolds number equal to rho u x1 divided by mu, which is 1.177 into 2 into 0.2 divided by 1.85 into 10 power minus 5, which is 25,448.6. Now the boundary layer thickness at this position, delta x equal to 0.2 equal to 5x divided by Reynolds number to the power of 5, 0.5, which is equal to 5 into 0.2 divided by 25,448.6 to the power of 0.5 equal to 6.27 10 power minus 3 meter. At x equal to 0.4 meter, so Reynolds number equal to rho u x2 divided by mu, so which is 1.177 into 2 into 0.4 divided by 1.85 into 10 power minus 5 equal to 50,897.2. So the boundary layer thickness delta at x equal to 0.4, which is 5x divided by Reynolds number to the power 0.5. So 5 into 0.4 divided by 50,897.2 to the power 0.5, which is 8.86 in 10 power minus 3 meter. Now the mass flow rate entering between x equal to 0.2 and x equal to 0.4 meter. So mx equal to integrating 0 to delta from rho u dy, and 0 to delta integrating the substituting the velocity profile u value, so rho u infinity into 3 by 2 y by delta minus 1 by 2 y to the power 3 minus delta to the power 3 into dy, and this velocity profile, so this is available in the textbook. You can refer to the textbook for the velocity profile for flow over flat plate. And integrating and substituting the limit, so this is 5 by 8 rho u infinity into delta. Substituting the limit, you will get the m value equal to 5 by 8 rho u infinity into delta. Now the mass flow rate entering the boundary layer, so delta m equal to 5 by 8 rho u infinity, this delta value at x equal to 0.4 minus delta value at x equal to 0.2. Now this is 5 by 8 into 1.177 into velocity is 2 meters per second. And we have the value 8.6 in 10 power minus 3 minus 6.27 10 power minus 3 equal to 3.18 10 power minus 3 kilograms per second. Now the mass flow rate between the position x equal to 0.4 and x equal to 0.2 equal to 3.18 10 power minus 3 kilograms per second. This is the answer to the problem. And these are all the reference book I used for preparing the slides. So you can refer to it for theoretical background, theoretical knowledge and additional problems. So I have published a book on the subject. You can refer to it for additional problem on the force convection external flow. And if you have any queries on the subject, you can write to me in the mail ID. So I will sincerely answer to all your queries. So thank you. We'll meet again.